Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Last time, we were tasked with coming up here, up this little mountain right here, and killing a Lynel. Or, well, we didn't necessarily have to kill the Lynel. We just had to take his shock arrows. But we killed him anyway, because he got aggro. And in this episode, I actually want to go ahead and go into the pause menu really quick and go to the system screen. And down to ability controls. Because as you'll see, there's a few missing. We haven't unlocked all of the ability controls, but I feel like we've done everything. So certain things will only unlock when you talk to certain NPCs. For example, I believe one of these is Jump Strike, which we've done a ton. So at some point, we're going to have to go back and grab those. Anyway, we're about to jump off this giant cliff. Oh my god, this is further down than I thought it was. There's Varuta. Ah, the East Reservoir Lake. I would be lying if I said that I thought that there was gonna be a Korok, I'm not gonna lie. I thought there was gonna be a Korok from jumping off there. But apparently not. Look at that thing. Giant elephant robot. Also, I saw something in the wall. Is that just birds? What is that? Oh yeah, it's like ducks. Okay. Alright, we gotta go meet with Sidon. Honestly, I wouldn't have jumped into the water had I known there wasn't gonna be anything there. Because we could have just paraglided all the way down to Sidon, but... You know what? It's fine. Where is he? Wait, is he up there? No, he's down here. I'm dumb. There he is, over there. Ooh, this is a nice little area. We got anything hidden? Anything hidden over here? Oh, is that a bed? Yeah, I'll have a nap. No, we don't need a nap right now. It's 10 a.m. It's actually 10 a.m. in real life, too. I'm matched with Link very temporarily. Hi, Sidon. How you doing? Glad to see you're ready to go, Link. Are you ready for this? Do you have your Zora armor and enough shock arrows? I'm not wearing the Zora armor, but I have it. Wonderful! You never cease to amaze, Link. Now then, let us go appease that divine beast as one. Here we go! Wait a second. Now that I look closer, I see that you're not wearing the Zora armor. Unless you have enough shock arrows and your Zora armor- buddy. I'm just not wearing it, like I have it. Hang on, it's down here. Now I'm ready. I think we just broke Sidon's heart. I kind of feel bad. Yeah, I'm ready to go. You don't have to repeat all your dialogue again. I promise you, you don't. You don't? No, he's doing it anyway. I'm ready, Sidon. I am more than ready right now. Here we go! Gaze now upon the divine beast's back. Do you see those glowing pink orbs? You will need to shoot each of them with a shock arrow. With your Zora armor, you will have the ability to ascend waterfalls. So I shall take you right up to the side of the divine beast, and from there you can swim up and take him. Take aim. I know you can do it. I believe in you. Now, hurry up and get on my back. I'm ready. Good answer. Let's get going. Okay, here we go. Ha! I'm unstoppable in the water! Ruta is responding to our presence. I'll move away and wait for an opening before we approach. I'll keep going at full speed. It's up to you to ward off Ruta's attacks. Are you ready? Divine Beast Varuta will undoubtedly use its ancient and mysterious powers against us. That includes hurling giant ice blocks that we will need to watch out for. I shall leave those to you. Oh! Awkward loading aside. Let's put on Cryonis. Because I know all about ice blocks. There we go. Boom. Boom. Here we go. Oh, this is so flippin' cool, dudes. This is- swim upward! Thank you, Sidon! Ah! Here we are. Paraglide down a little bit. Let's get our shock arrows out. And let's do a better bow. We don't want to waste all of our Lynel bow right now, do we? Silver bow. Eh. Got it. Oh, can we hit that one from here? Oh, we did. We got them both. Oh, hi, Sidon. One more time, okay.
Can we get rid of the house?
I will, yeah. Just give me a second there. Oh, God, turn the camera. Oh, no. There we go. That was almost really bad. Come on. Break that one, and... Whoop. Come on. There we go. Got it, Sidon. Let's do this. Oh, we're at its rear end now, okay. Up we go! Can we do this in one time, in one go again? I'm gonna try and get the one that's further away first. I think we got it. Yes! Wow, that was astounding! An absolute thrill! Link, look! The water spouting from Ruta has slowed down. Ruta is floating higher now. You wanted to venture inside it, right? I'll bring you closer. We're counting on you, hero. Do good work in there. You can come with me if you want, Sidon.
Well, Link, here we are. Looks like this is where the real work starts. Best of luck. Nice job cutting off the water flow from this divine beast. Show the enemy no fear. I'll see you back at Zor's domain. Farewell.
Know why he had to leave. He could have come back. He could have come into the Divine Beast with us, and we could have had a nice buddy bro time adventure. But apparently, Sidon doesn't feel like it. I mean, there's probably electrical hazards.
The guidance stone there contains the information that you will need.
Alright, here we are, Divine Beast Varuta. And as it said, it has now been registered as a travel gate, so we could technically leave now if we want. We can just head back to Zora's domain and really, really confuse Sidon. But it means that we can leave at any time we need to. Also, we only use 4 arrows. Hello. It means we can leave at any time that we need to, should we need to go get more items or health or anything like that. So, oh, that's Guardian Scout. And it's dead. Okay, that thing went down much easier than I expected. Let's grab its stuff. Ancient Screw, Ancient Spring. Now, I did see there was a chest in this water. There it is. I would like to grab that. So, this is essentially our first dungeon. Like, Zelda games are pretty well known for having dungeons in them. Ancient Spring, okay. However, Breath of the Wild, it really doesn't, because it's a big open world game. But it does have the Divine Beast, so there are essentially 4 major dungeons in this game, because they're all, as you'll see shortly when we get this map, they're bloody huge and they're full of puzzles, and I'm really excited for this. Thank you.
Sheikah Blade authenticated. Distilling map of Divine Beast. Divine Beast controls have been enabled.
It's an elephant! I mean, we knew it was an elephant, but...
Good. You've obtained the map of the Divine Beast. You will see several glowing points on your map which represent the terminals that control Ruta. Take Ruta back by activating all of the terminals. Be careful.
Will do, Mipha. Will do. So we got a little mini map down there now. We have... Oh, it's really tiny. Hang on. There we go. We have 5 different points that we need to get to within this Divine Beast. One of them is right at the end of the trunk, which I feel like is just going to be a real pain in the keister to get to. Come on, Link. We got our Zora armor. We can swim. We can swim well. I'm going to have stasis on just so I can notice stuff, because I don't recall if the Divine Beast icon on the map shows the treasure chest next to it when you collect everything. I'm unsure if it does that like shrines do. So I want to just ensure that we do actually get everything. In fact, I think we can start off by going lower. Can we? Let's find out. Or maybe not. Maybe this was a bad idea. Was it? Oh no, we're fine. We're fine. Can we climb on this stuff? I guess we can, right? Well, we're somewhere. We found something. Oh, this is terrifying. Hello. Found our first terminal, I suppose. Sheikah Slate authenticated. Unable to activate main control unit. Unactivated terminals remain. Oh. This is the main controls, and I just skipped right to the main controls, apparently. Alright then, good to know. So is it in here, though? Because I'm trying to... Let me get a better look. It's to our right. Okay. And then we can also do this. We can move the trunk, which, as you'll see right here... This is essentially the water temple. Our first dungeon is the water temple, which is a little terrifying. But the trunk's gonna go up, as you can see on the mini-map. And it's gonna start doing that! It's gonna... Oh. Okay, no, it's not the water temple. For some reason, I thought that it was gonna fill this area up with water. That is, fun fact, not what happened. We got this, though. Oh, there we go. What is this gonna do? Oh, it's raising it out of the water! Yeah! Yeah, got it. Let's go, Link. So, we've just got this place filling with water right now. I don't think it's gonna fill up fully, but we'll see.
There are 4 terminals remaining. Don't give up.
Working on it, Mipha. Don't you worry, sweetheart. I am working on it. Yeah, so that just rotates that thing in the middle. And I feel like it also did something else. We can also put it like halfway. What does that do? I'm having to relearn this stuff because it has been a while. Oh, that rotates it the other way. That makes a lot of sense, or it almost did. Okay, well, I'm just going to put it back down for now while we figure out what the heck else we're doing. What else we got going on in here? Okay, so I see where we are now. We're back in the same room we were in before. That is not ice. That is a wall. That is a cliffside, in fact. This is where we started. I'm getting my bearings all kinds of messed up right now. Alright, so that's the butt of the elephant, and that's where the main control unit is. We gotta keep that in mind. Alright, we're gonna head back out here and head up. I headed back down for some reason, thinking that that's where the terminal was. It wasn't, as we found out. Hi! I wasn't expecting another one of you. Well, I guess I probably was, actually. You're everywhere. There we go, got to use our Lynel sword. In fact, we have a Korok leaf. Yeah, let me go ahead and drop that. Because we do not need it right now. I'm gonna pick up this sword. Pick up all of those things. Okay, got a chest up there. Okay, good to know. Keep that in mind. Is this above where we just were? Yes, it is. Okay, so we... I think what we have to do is that. Might be a little bit more, because... I think we can stasis this? Oh, we can stasis that bit right there. Because there's a treasure chest right there, but it's got something blocking it off. Was that enough? I don't think that was enough. Where's the trunk? One more? Am I looking the wrong way? No, it's over there. Bro. Ruta, are you gonna do your job? Where's your trunk? Why can't I see it? There it is. It just wasn't quite far enough. Alright, now this is gonna rotate. We should be able to hop on. And is there anything up top here for us? I mean, there's gotta be. Otherwise, why would we be able to get on here? Not a fan of this water, though. This might hurt. That didn't hurt. I'm really surprised. That's really fast-moving water. Goodbye. Oh, damn it. Okay, Guardian Spear. Don't really want it. Okay. Oh. Oh. Oh, is that just an easy way back up now? Is that gonna stay on permanently? Yeah, okay, good. We have a permanent, easier way back up here. Very nice. Okay, so I want to try and get the chest that's in the middle. I believe there's... I want to say there's also a terminal in here. Because once this rotates around, it's going to activate... Or it's going to put something into that. Which... Oh, I know exactly what that is, actually. Once the ball goes in there... Ah, wait a minute. Yeah, it opens that up, but the problem is... That's upside down, and that's where the terminal is, so we have to stasis that in place... before it moves back, and then, that's not gonna work, is it? We can't get in there. Hello, treasure chest. You're gonna be a pain to open, I think. Oh no, we can stasis... Link. We can stasis this one. Oh, that, not like that. Oh, I'm bad at this. I'm so bad at this, I think we need to be back up top to make this a little bit easier. Maybe. It's gonna take a little bit for me to actually learn how this dungeon works again. Cause, oh. Okay, cool, I'll take that chest. I remember this one ooh, Knight's Halberd. I remember this one taking me a while in my first playthrough. A spear used by Knights Adept in mounted combat, the spearhead is modeled after an axe. Okay, well, I want to pick it up because it's in the dungeon, so we'll get rid of the Lazal spear. I think the Lazal spear just vanished out of existence. Okay. So, if we can get further around, like around here, might be able to get a better view. Can we climb? Oh my god, we can't. I mean, I guess that makes sense. You can't climb most ancient stuff. We can do that, though. Oh, that's definitely gonna work. Yes! Good job, Link. We are definitely not supposed to be up here. Oh. Like, they obviously intend for you to not be able to get up here. Okay. Okay. Wrong button, Link. Wrong button. No. Come on, we did it once, and then I fell down like an idiot. Okay. Ugh, okay. That's one. Now, can we get up just a little further? There we go. Alright, this is much better. It would be better if we were on the other side, but... It's okay. Alright, so... I want to get the terminal first, we'll worry about the chest after. Because... We've got to do it... I think what we want to do, actually... wait, am I being stupid? Don't answer that. I think, actually, if we just have it rotate the other way, we've got a better shot of this working. Because if we do that, and then we... Actually, no, I think we just turn off Ruta now. I didn't really need to stasis that in- Oh no, that's not right. That's not right, this is upside down, that's right. Let's have it rotate the other way. Let's do that and see what happens. Just as soon as Ruta gets its trunk back up. Cause... God, I'm telling you, man, this is... It's probably a really simple solution. I'm just not the biggest brain out there. So it's gonna take me a little bit to figure this out. We also have to kinda... Okay. All right. We also have to, like, actually get into that chamber, which we haven't done yet. Like, there's, like, a little, there's a little ramp. So I guess maybe we want to go over that way first. Oh, our spear landed up there, apparently. Okay. Yeah, let's head down to this bit, because this is how we get... Oh my god, Link. This is how we get into the little, chamber thingy that has the thing in it. Yeah, I'm making a lot of sense, and these are all words. They sure are words, they're just not necessarily in the right spot. Alright, stasis that. I don't think that's gonna work. I think we gotta stasis it again. Okay, no, we can't stasis again that fast. Why did I think that would work? How do we do this? I don't... Am I having a bruh moment? I think actually the other way was correct. I just didn't realize that there was this platform right here. I'm keeping all... Oh, wait, no! There! Then stasis it. Oh, we just have to get it as it's rotating back. Oh, big brain time.
She gets laid on dedicated.
There are three terminals remaining. You can do it.
Yeah, I don't know about that one, Mipha. I am having a time right now. Oh, I need the other thing to deactivate. Whoops. Oh, actually, no, wait. I'm curious if this works. If I just whack this a few times, is that gonna work? Probably not. No, I know exactly what I have to do. I have to get that to rotate back, and then change Ruta's direction again like this. So that goes down. Stasis, wait for it. Stasis that one in place. Yeah, okay, now we just have to get the chest. Link, get the chest and then get out before you get crushed, is what I was gonna say. Ancient core, I did all of that work for an ancient core, okay. It's fine, we got it figured out, we did the puzzle. Puzzle complete. Hello there. Evil eyeball thing. I guess this is probably how you were intended on getting up to that platform, and I just went a completely different way. Well, that's okay. That's okay, that's fine. But it's creepy. It's nighttime now. It's really creepy being in this giant open area. Oh, this is... different? Because that one's in the water. Can we lower the water level? Wait a minute. Can I put a block on there? Ah! Oh, that lowers it! Oh! I actually didn't know that was gonna work, but we take those.
She gets my top indicated.
There are two terminals remaining. You're nearly there.
We got this, Link. I think. I do see a chest that I want to grab, up to the right over here. Unsure how we get up there, though. Because that's Ruta's butt right there. Well, I guess we can probably just... Can we just go, like, over here? Okay. I don't know why I thought I could make that jump. I'm having a big old small brain moment today, apparently. Alright. What I was gonna say, we just go over here. We stand on this, and then can I deactivate that Cryonis? Yeah. And then that rotates us around. And then I think we can just make the jump? Maybe! Yes, we can! Look at that. Using my noggin. Okay. Silver rupee! I'll take $100. Alright, so we're right above the main terminal now. We have one up in its head and one at the end of its trunk. So, oh, there's fire up there. You see that? I don't think that was there before, was it? Maybe it was. Maybe. Let's head back up to its head then. We have an immediate way up with the waterfall right here. Well, let's not drown while we're at it, Link. That'd be great. Like, oh, yeah, there's fire. What the heck? Okay, that's different. So how on earth do we get up there? Also, something just... I'm recording off of my PC screen and an update just decided to appear on the screen. Fantastic. Okay, I guess we just do this and test, see what happens. Because I didn't notice the fire before. Maybe Ruta was putting out the fire. That's always a possibility. Because I don't see any other way through here. Is there a way beneath us? Because that was just the... That was just the terminal room, I believe. Wasn't it? Oh, no. What the heck? It was just this the whole time? And I didn't notice it? Oh, we're out of stamina. Wow, I can't believe I didn't notice that. That's incredible. Okay, we're at the trunk now. So if we go ahead and put this down... Yeah, we can move it over. I'm gonna try and see if there's anything else out here we can grab while we're here. Huh? Okay, there's a chest right there on its trunk. Let's just go ahead and take down the evil eyeball. Was that good? Okay, yeah, it had like a weird mouth too. That made me a little uncomfortable, not gonna lie. Okay. Ancient shaft. Okay then. Now, how on earth do we climb this bit? Can we climb this bit? Because there's something in its trunk. I don't think we can climb that part. I think we actually need to move this back up. You can see there's like a tiny platform on the other side of the trunk. So I'm gonna move it back up. I'm gonna hope Link doesn't fall and die. Maybe. Oh, it's going a little too far. Oh no. Whew! We're okay. We're really high up now, but... I don't know how we get to the actual trunk part, because we can't climb this, can we? Oh. Well, we can climb it a little bit. But I don't think this was the intended method. If we lower it down, can we... glide? I'm just gonna do it by one. Is it gonna go down fa- Oh my god, look at that.
Oh no, it's not far enough down!
No. Lower it. Glide. Oh boy. Okay, okay. Now we gotta put it back up again. Oh, that's so cool. I didn't realize it worked like that, but that's really cool. You can just change it while you're gliding. I guess I figured it out eventually on my previous playthrough, right? Because I completed the Divine Beast Varuta on my first playthrough, but... I don't remember it being like this, but that's really cool. Or I don't remember the solution being like that. Alright, there we go.
She gets laid off.
Just one terminal remaining. I have faith in you.
Thanks, Lady Mipha. Appreciate it. So, it's in its head, as we know. Ooh. There's a chest over there. And there's another evil eyeball over there. Let's raise it up. Just a tad more. So we can get a little bit closer. All the way. Why not? I don't think we're gonna fall off. Oh, we might fall off. Okay, we'll just go here.
Okay.
Alright, I don't know if we're gonna be able to make it all the way to the other side from here. In fact, I think the evil eyeball is on the other side. Oh, damn it. Okay. Is it there? I think that's the evil eyeball. Yeah! But is there anything on that side? No. But it did get rid of the malice over here, so we take those. We absolutely take those. Ice arrow. Okay. Very cool. Very cool. Now, as for where we're going next... Into the head of the beast, I suppose. There's a hole right here. Looks like we're right above it, so... Hello? Oh! You can just make those? Cool. Very interesting. Where was the fire? Oh, it's right there. Oh, is that the terminal? That is the terminal. Oh, wait a minute. There's a thingy. There's a thingamajig. What does that do? Oh, it opens up the head! Or like the bit above the head. And then I guess we can do this. And have water come down and put out the fire? That's absolutely terrifying to watch in real time. I didn't like that. I didn't like that at all. Okay. Cool. Again, this should hurt. Getting hit by this much water as a little Hylian boy would hurt.
She can play dominated.
You activated all the terminals. Now you can start the main control unit. There should be a new glowing mark on your map. Head there. Be careful not to let your guard down.
All right, folks, we have opened up the way, or we have opened up access to the main terminal right down in the elephant's ass, and we are going to be taking that on, or going down there and seeing what's going on with it, I should say. Taking on that little part of the mission in the next episode. I also want to just make sure I've got all the chests in here. Let me go... Oh, I guess I can't go back to the... Can I not go back to the full map? Oh, I guess not. I guess when we were outside, it was just like, hey, yeah, here, you can teleport here. But now that we're inside, it's not going to let us do that. So what, wait, if we just go outside then, is this where we got in? This is not where we came in. Well, whatever. We could teleport sort of kind of earlier, but not anymore, apparently. So yeah, we're going to be doing that in the next episode, folks. We've done it. I completed this a lot faster than I anticipated, because I remember this taking me absolutely forever on my first playthrough, so I'm legitimately surprised that we knocked it out this fast. Okay, so if I go out here, can I teleport? No, we have to actually hit the A button to leave. It's weird that it showed the map before and it's not doing it now. I guess it's because we got the Divine Beast controls. Anyway, folks, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Breath of the Wild. Next time, as I said, main control unit, and hopefully taking back Varuta. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.